Sawadeeka, welcome to ASEAN Weekly. I'm Sandra Han Utsaha. In tonight's episode, we'll be speaking with Mr. Kabir Singh of UNESCO Bangkok about UNESCO's synthesis report on school-related violence and bullying on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity or expression, or what is called SOGI. But first of all, we're going to take a look at the recent happenings this past week in ASEAN.
Tungshang District in Thailand's Nan Province has held an ASEAN forest planting activity as part of a campaign promoting security and strength in villages along the Thailand-Laos border, enhancing both countries' relations. The campaign was organized after a meeting between the district chief of Tungshang and the governor of Chinhon District in Thayaburi Province of Laos. The meeting, which was attended by police and military officers and government officials from both nations, was about the enhancement of both countries' relations among neighboring cities along the border. It is expected that the ASEAN reforestation campaign will benefit residents from both districts of the two nations. The program also forced stronger bonds between Thai and Laotian peoples, preventing conflicts in the future. Malaysia's last male Sumatran rhinoceros has died, dashing efforts to save the critically endangered species in the country. The rhino named Tam was about 30 years old and lived at a wildlife reserve in Sabah State on Borneo Island since his capture in 2008. The Sumatran rhino, the smallest species of rhinoceros, was declared extinct in the wild in Malaysia in 2015. Aiman, a female captured in 2014, is now the only surviving member of the subspecies left in the country. Since 2011, Malaysia has tried to breed the species in captivity through the vitro fertilization, but without success. Officials said Tam's genetic material has been preserved for the future attempts to reproduce Sumatran rhinos.
That is it for our first segment. Stay tuned for our interview with Mr. Kabir Singh of UNESCO Bangkok about the synthesis report on school-related violence and bullying on the basis of what is known as SOGI.
In 2019, Thailand is ready for ASEAN chairmanship, working together and building solidarity to increase competitiveness and innovation with the people at the center. All sectors are ready to promote unity of the ASEAN community. NBT World is excited to be a full supporter of the Thai ASEAN chairmanship. Keep up to date on ASEAN 2019 movement with NBT World.
To ASEAN Weekly. School-related violence and bullying is a problem in every single country, and UNESCO has launched a report on school-related violence and bullying on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity or expression, or what is known as SOGI. And to help us understand this more, we're going to speak to Mr. Kabir Singh, the Regional Advisor of UNESCO for HIV and Health. Sawadeeka.
Sawadeeka.
Khun Kabir, thank you so much for joining us on ASEAN Weekly. So we're hoping that in your role as Regional Advisor of HIV and Health for UNESCO, that you can help us understand the school-related violence and bullying on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity or expression synthesis report. Can you tell us about the background of the report?
Sure. Thank you so much for inviting me, Sandy. So in 2015, UNESCO Bangkok released a regional review called From Insult to Inclusion. And it was the first such regional review that looked at the current situation in the region relating to school violence and bullying that takes place on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity or expression. Mm-hmm. In the same year, we also had a regional consultation with 13 countries in the region, including five from ASEAN, Cambodia, Indonesia, Myanmar, the Philippines, and Thailand, mm-hmm. to look at what we know about this situation mm-hmm. and what more needs to be done. And in 2016, we followed up on that regional review and the consultation to actually have four consultations in countries, China, Thailand, Philippines, and in Vietnam, to find out in a more deeper way about good practices, but also the causes, consequences, manifestations, and the scale of this issue in the region.
Okay, so that's the background and the objectives of the report itself.
Yes, and there's an additional objective other than actually understanding the situation, a very important objective around advocacy for collaborative action. Mm. It's very important for us to understand that this situation of school violence and bullying is not unique to any one country, but is prevalent in many countries in the region. So it's really important that we learn from each other, especially within the setting of ASEAN, to make sure that we are able to make a change in a positive way.
Okay, so you said that the report focuses on China, the Philippines, Thailand, and Vietnam. Why these four countries? Does this imply that these problems are found mostly in these nations?
No, not at all. As I mentioned, it's prevalent in all countries in the region. And the reasons for choosing this were manifold, including our programmatic engagement with UNDP, which is a UN agency that we partnered with this for this, but also because of our engagement in the country on these issues. But more importantly, the ability for us to be able to show good practices, the ability for us to actually show what the situation is and what the data is telling us. These four countries are where we went as a first step, but by no means does it mean that it doesn't exist in other countries.
Okay, so can you tell us now, what are the main drivers of the violence and bullying in China, Philippines, and Thailand and Vietnam for what we call its SOGI, is that correct?
Correct, sexual orientation and gender identity or expression. I think it's important, if I may, for your viewers to explain that what we call school-related gender-based violence, which is part of a global guidance that UNESCO and UN Women released in 2016, is defined as acts or threats of physical, sexual, or psychosocial violence that happens in or around schools because of gender and social norms and stereotypes, but also because of unequal power dynamics. And sexual violence and bullying that we're talking about today, school violence and bullying, sorry, is a type of SRGBV that happens because of the way the society sees gender norms and stereotypes. And some of the key drivers, the most important one, is that communities and societies in our region tend to box people into you're either a man or a woman.
Right.
So you're either masculine or feminine.
Right, that's not the case.
And in societies, they also tend to see it to be purely heteronormal, which is it's only between men and women. Whereas we realize that you cannot box people and should not box people into this binary way of seeing the world. So that's a really key driver, is violence that happens because young people and children don't necessarily conform to this binary way of seeing the world. The second one is that violence relating to sexual orientation and gender identity or expression is quite normalized. It doesn't just happen in school settings, but it happens within the home, it happens in workplace settings as well and in the community. And in many ways, because of the way society sees in such a binary way, it's normalized. So it's almost like an extension of what's already happening in wider society. The third driver is the lack of good quality, comprehensive sexuality education. Now, sexuality education is really critical because it enables from a very young age for children and young people to have a better sense about their own body, about their own body processes, about the uniqueness of each individual. It gives young people the knowledge, the skills, but also the attitudes to better understand the cognitive, social, and emotional skills that all of us need to transition into adulthood. And reviews show that sexuality education in our region does require strengthening, and much more can be done. And the final one is really about policies, the lack of policies and legal recourse to be able to address such violence that takes place, both in education settings, but also within the wider community.
So as you mentioned, the report says that one of the seeds for violence is actually the lack of good quality, comprehensive sexuality education. Can you tell us more about this particular topic?
So UNESCO actually just released a global guidance on comprehensive sexuality education. It's called the International Technical Guidance on Sexuality Education, and this was released in January of 2018. And it's very important to mention that Thailand is in the process. We are translating it for Thailand, and it will be released in June of this year in Thai language, so that Thailand can strengthen and improve what's already happening. Now, CSE, as it's known for short, is a curriculum frame, is a curriculum response that takes place in schools to be able to give children and young people the skills, the attitudes, and the knowledge to equip them to be able to take informed decisions about their own bodies, about their own lives, but also to understand how it affects others. So it's a very important enabler which provides a foundation for life and love for all children and young people. And UNESCO actually released a campaign last year called A Foundation for Life and Love, showcasing the true value that sexuality education has mm-hmm. for children and young people everywhere.
Mm-hmm. And so you said that the guidance is being translated into Thai, and it's being supported by the Thai government. So are we expecting to see this actually being built into the curricula at school?
Well, the guidance itself is a UN document. As you can imagine, we as United Nations cannot be prescriptive because we have to use this guidance across a range of contexts. However, by translating it into Thai, it's a very important first step to enable the Thai government to get the most updated evidence. It's a starting point for us to make sure that everyone who's engaged in sexuality education, mm-hmm. from the policy level to programming people to civil society, but also youth advocates, have the most updated information and knowledge so that we can start to see what more can we do. Mm-hmm. And we're hopeful that Thailand, who's made great strides in terms of gender equality, but also have had sexuality education since 1978, will move forward in making sure that the best practices that we know are in some way incorporated into mm-hmm. Thailand's mm-hmm. response.
Right. So the current synthesis report is, again, on China, the Philippines, Thailand, and Vietnam. Do you see the possibility of the research being expanded to other ASEAN countries, and what can Thailand do as ASEAN chair this year?
So, as I mentioned, these four countries is just a first step mm-hmm. For a range of programmatic reasons that we chose them. We must do more in the region. Another reason why we didn't have other countries represented was there isn't enough data necessarily on some of the specifics around mm-hmm. the causes, the manifestations, mm-hmm. but also consequences. So we are committed as UNESCO Bangkok to do more in the region. And I think Thailand can and must do more as the chair of ASEAN. I think if you look at how school violence and bullying adversely affects children and young people, both in terms of educational outcomes, for example, school dropouts. There are also higher rates of depression, suicide ideation. It affects their grades, but also health outcomes. I think it's very important that we don't allow school violence and bullying to have a lifelong effect on aspects relating to employability, which is obviously an important pillar, looking at ASEAN and the economic aspect of it. But also, we must enable the social and emotional learning of children and young people to be able to form healthy and respectful relationships, which would be key in taking both Thailand, but also ASEAN forward.
Mm-hmm. So we have about 30 seconds left. Is there anything special you'd like to say to our viewers?
I think Thailand is in a very unique position as the chair of ASEAN to show leadership in ensuring that all children and young people don't face violence and discrimination in the education settings. This is really important because a lot of the school violence and bullying has a lifelong impact that has a bearing on the economic aspect in terms of employability, but also in terms of their health and well-being. And if we are, as Thailand, but also ASEAN as a region, achieve the Sustainable Development Goals, we must and can do more to make sure that the demographic dividend of this region is leveraged in a positive and supportive way.
Okay, Khun Kinnear, I've learned so much, and I'm sure our viewers have as well. Thank you so much for speaking with us for ASEAN Weekly. Khop khun ka. Sawasdee ka. And that was Kabir Singh, the regional advisor for UNESCO on HIV and health, talking to us about the school-related violence and bullying on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity or expression, which is also known as SOGI. And that is it for ASEAN Weekly. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Sian Trahan Utsaha, and it's been a pleasure. Sawasdee ka.